to 15 Days Yoga Program, and this is Richa. Today is day 11. I hope you are enjoying doing yoga with me so far. Today we are going to do slightly intense workout. We are going to work on our sides and legs. We'll be working on our glutes. And if you need a break anytime, pause this video, take a break and come back. So let's start. So we are going to start with side lunge. Stand at the back of your mats. Step forward on your right leg. Bend your right knee. And keep both hands on your knee. And stay there. We are just going to start pulsing. Just going down. 1, 2, 3. We will do 10 times. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. If you feel like repetitions are too much, you can do 5 now. Keep your right leg straight and take it back. Let's do for the left leg the same thing. Let's start. Keep bouncing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now keep your left leg back. So now we are going to do this again. Step forward on your right leg. Keep pulsing. And with every breath, go down. Ensure your back is remain straight and your knee should be at 90 degree angle. And now, let's change side. Now for the left leg. Step forward, left leg and pulse. Back is straight. Keep pulsing. And now straight your left leg and take your leg back. Now standing on your mats, keep your heels together, keep your back straight, and now we are going to raise right leg up, flexing your foot and just kick on your side. Ensure that you are able to balance, and if you are not able to balance, you can take support from the wall. Just make yourself comfortable. And now slowly get your leg down. Now transfer the weight on your other leg and start. Make sure your heels are together. Just make yourself comfortable. And now slowly get your leg down. Now once again transferring the weight on right leg. Pulse. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now on the other side. And pulse. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Nice. Now step your legs to side. We are going to do wide leg squats. You sit and bend your knees. Make sure your knees are at 90 degree angle and your back remain straight. From the side angle, go down and ensure that your back is straight, abdomen is pulled in nicely, so you don't want to push down or slouch forward. Exhale as you going down and inhale, you come up. Hold your leg muscles tight Exhale, down. Inhale, up. Exhale, down. Inhale, up. So we are going to do 20 of these. And if you feel like 20 is too much, you can do 10 or 5. Or if you can do more than 20, you can pause the video and do it. Exhale, down. Inhale, up. Exhale. Inhale, up. Exhale, down. Inhale, up. Now exhale down and hold here for 10 count. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And let's stand up and relax. Now come to Marjorasana. Bend your right knee up. And now what we're going to do, we are going to pulse for 5 times up like this, and then we are going to open our leg and hold there for 5 count and then down. Let's start. Pulse 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now open and hold there for 5 count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and close. Again, raising leg up, pulse 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and hold for 5 count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and close. Now one more last time. Pulse 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and hold for 5 count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and close and relax. Stay in center, feel the burn. Breathe. Now stretch your leg to back. Flex your foot. Now we are going to kick 10 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Take your leg in and feel the burn on your legs. Now one more time, stretch your leg to the back and kick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Now switch side. We are going to do the same procedure for left leg. Now bend your left knee and pulse. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and hold for 5 count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and close. Again, raising leg up, pulse. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now open and hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and down. Now one more last time. Pulse up. 1, 2, 3. Feel the burn. 4, 5. Open and hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and relax. Stay in center, feel the burn, breathe. Now stretch your leg to the back, flex your foot and let's start kicking. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now take your leg in, feel the burn on your leg. And one more time, stretch your leg to the back and kick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And now take your leg back and let's relax in child pose. Be there. Relax yourself. And now quickly come up into inverted V pose. Posture 7 of Surya Namaskar and stretch nicely. Move your knees. Keep moving nicely. Stretch nicely. Now get your knees down and we are going to lay down on our mats. Ensure you keep your body in one straight line. Keep your abdomen muscle pulled in nicely. Breathe. Now we are going to do one of my favorite exercises, and this really works on your core. It works on your sides and inner thighs. You will really feel the stretch. Now inhale, raise your both legs off the floor. Keep your feet together. As you exhale, raise your upper leg up and slowly keep your leg down and come down. Maintain your balance. Keep your palms for more support, and we are going to do 5 of these. So inhale, raise your both legs off the floor and upper leg will go up, and as you exhale your leg will come down and both legs on the floor. Again inhale, both legs off the floor and keep your upper leg up. Now keep your upper leg down and slowly come down. Maintain your balance. Again inhale, both legs up. Up again. Down and come down. One more time. Inhale up. Up. Down and down. One last time. Inhale, both legs up. Up, down, and come down. Now we're going to switch side. If you feel it on your side of your waist, then you are doing it correctly. Now change side and start. Inhale up, up, down, and come down. Again, inhale up, up, down and come down. Inhale up, up, down, come down. Inhale up, up, down, come down. And the last time, inhale up, up, down and come down. Again, come to Marjorasana and we are going to do one last stretch. Go to posture 7 and start from posture 7. Walk the right leg forward close to the mat, close to your hands, and other leg slide on the mat. Make sure your weight should be equal on both sides. This is called pigeon pose. If you feel any pressure on your right hip, you can keep a towel to support. Now slide hands forward. Be very gentle, very slowly. And now you will feel that your right hip is opening up, stretching, and then If you can, you're comfortable, you can keep your head on the floor. Maintain the balance. It's very relaxing pose for the lower back. Just stay there for a few seconds. And now slowly come back. And try to lift your neck and try to look up to the ceiling. Yeah, and now slowly come back to posture 7. Move your knees. And this time, left leg forward, close to the mat, close to your hands, and other leg slide on the mat. Again, make sure your weight should be equal on both sides. And see and feel that your left hip is opening up. Now slide your hands forward. And touch the floor with your head. Stay there. Breathe. Just feel the stretch. Maintain your balance. Don't worry about the perfection. And now slowly come up. Look up to the ceiling. And go back to posture 7. And go to child pose. So we focused a lot today on our legs, thighs, side muscles, glutes, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you feel leg pain, don't worry, it's a good pain. Just keep working out. The best way to get rid of pain is to keep working out. Now slowly come up. That was fantastic. I'll see you tomorrow. Have a great day and namaste.